Hi everyone, welcome back. So for some reason my TikTok video where I react to TikToks about self-harm has become very very popular. And since I made this one, you guys have been requesting another one. So that's what I'm gonna do today. I'm gonna go on TikTok and react to TikToks about self-harm. Like I said in the other video, I'm really not that familiar with TikTok. This is gonna be the second time that I ever go on TikTok. So if there are things that I don't get or anything like that, just tell me in the comments. Maybe I'm just missing things out. Okay, so let's find a random one, like this one. I just want you back. I'm running to your side, flying my white flag, my white flag. I think most of you know what I'm gonna say. This is not self-harm. This is a self-destructive behavior. This is self-neglect. This is not self-harm. I've talked about that often enough. I'm gonna link some videos here if you wanna know more about why I say that. A big red flag for mental health though. Something that should be taken very seriously. It's just not self-harm.
OMG, you're so funny and quirky! Actually, after 3 years from suffering with it, I've been clean. So, take that shit somewhere else. Please. Or actually, don't take it anywhere else. Keep it to yourself.
I'm wondering where this idea that alternative people, especially goth type people, I guess you could say, are more prone to self-harm, because I don't think that's actually the case. I don't really know, I haven't done the research, but this is definitely a common idea. I don't know if it's a misconception or not, but it's definitely a common idea. Where do you think this comes from? Is it because it's kind of a gory type thing and goth are supposed to like gory type things? Or because you're already so different from the norm that just cutting yourself is not an issue anymore? I don't know, but it's very annoying. And I know I'm probably only reinforcing this stereotype, making videos about self-harm and looking like this. I know, but what can I do? I'm not gonna change my hair color and my piercings just because I don't want to enforce a stereotype.
See? I hate me too. Now we can be friends again.
So sad, because it is so true, right? How hard is it to tell someone that you have been relapsing? And I think this is why sometimes people just don't tell people and they just want to recover alone, because they're so afraid of disappointing people. Because you know this is something you're not supposed to do, right? You know this is something that is detrimental to yourself, to your skin obviously, to your mental health. And that is very, very upsetting usually to you, to people around you. But I think most of the time people will be sad for you that you have been in such a dark place again. But I don't think people will be disappointed in you and mad at you. Of course that can happen. And if that does happen, at the same time I can understand where they're coming from, because it can be very, very demanding and hard to be the loved one of someone who is self-harming, and it can be very scary. But at the same time, it's really not a constructive way of addressing this.
I'm realizing that I haven't really educated you guys on the reason why I self-harm. It is different for everyone, but my personal reason is it's more of a compulsion. I used to say that it's like an impulse thing, but there's a big difference between being impulsive and compulsive, and if you want, maybe I can get into that later. But it is a compulsion for me, and also an addiction. Just like any other addiction. Someone who's addicted to cocaine, you can't expect them to just quit overnight. It's a process, and I'm hoping that you guys will go through that with me.
Yeah, I definitely relate to what she's saying. I think what most people would call the compulsion would be an urge, but I can definitely relate, and I think most people can relate to that feeling, that urge of wanting to do something, and you know you shouldn't do it, right? But the urge is so, so strong, and your mind really has to work against itself to balance out this urge and not go through with it. And it's really not that easy. It may seem easy when you've never had an urge or an urge to self-harm, but when you've had one, it's very, very hard. To explain that to others, some people have used the analogy of wanting to go to the bathroom or really, really needing to eat because you haven't eaten something like 12 hours. It's basically how it feels. It feels like you really need it, and you really, really, really need it. But you, at the same time, know you don't really need it, but just because you know it doesn't really make it easier.
Remember how that lasted for a day?
Oh my god, that hit way too close to home. Oh my god, yeah. That's how I started too, and I think that's how many people started. You have to start with small steps, and even if you fail at the beginning, you still have to go on, and that's what I did, and now I have been clean for a few years. When my mom found out, I told her, no way, I'm never doing this again, and I did it like, what, 3 days later, maybe 2 days, because I was so addicted to it, and I was not gonna just stop overnight, even though I wanted to, because I saw how much it hurt her. But, yeah, hit close to home. That is actually self-harm, definitely. Just as a refresher, the definition that I use on this channel is a deliberate self-inflicted destruction of body tissue done without suicidal intent and for purpose not socially sanctioned. It's the definition from the ISSS. Hey, that you look when your steps make that much noise. Shh, I got you all figured out. Yep, that's self-harm in a nutshell. Don't know how to cope? Find an unhealthy coping skill. That doesn't mean you can't learn healthy coping skills. But if you don't, you're usually gonna use unhealthy ones.
I'm not afraid anymore!
Again, that's what's gonna happen usually at the beginning, at least, of your recovery journey. And this is something that always messes with my head. Sometimes there's like a huge life event and you don't feel like self-harming for some reason because, I don't know, you've got the support you need, or I think sometimes it has to do with realizing that it is a big event and then you put in place other coping skills. But sometimes very, very minor things, especially at the beginning of your recovery, will send your urges through the roof. And it just sometimes doesn't seem to make sense. It doesn't seem to correlate between the outside circumstance and the urge you get. And it can get very confusing. It's normal, not worry. We've all been there. Okay, that's gonna be it for today. As usual, if you wanna chat with me, you can hit me up on Instagram. Link is in the description. As always, I answer to every DM I get. And I will see you all very soon. Bye!